Nearly 22 years had passed since I, Denny Stump, first climbed Mt. Whitney in 1983. Many summits also had passed when, early in 2005, my good friend Bill Ball and I decided it was time for me to return to Mt. Whitney and time for Bill to make up for his absence in 1983. On September 10th, 2005, we left Pennsylvania and headed for the summit of the highest mountain in the contiguous 48 United States.
We'll call you on top.
Okay.
Bye.
Bye. There they go.
Lost Vegas. There we go. New week. It's a pyramid.
In case you doubt, we actually got here. Here's the skyline right from the hotel parking lot.
What's up, Ben?
Are we having fun?
What's up, bud?
What are you watching? Television?
I'm beer.
Huh?
Beer, dude.
Where are we going, Billy?
We are going to
you're fading out,
the Whitney Portal.
It's 96 miles till we turn to Death Valley.
Ooh,
bus. Just noticed how very green it is out here. They've had a lot of rain this year. And we're now heading into toward Death Valley. It's on the other side of those hills there. I had to cross that and then we're at the foot of Whitney. We'll get to sleep out for a couple nights.
Sand dunes out ahead there.
Sand dunes.
Death Valley is actually green, as Bill pointed out.
Coyote.
Scared to death of people, too, you can tell. I'm about to cross another big valley here, heading towards Lone Pine. Panamint Springs, a little wide spot in the road coming out of the valley. Excuse my horrible fast pan here, but that's where we just came from. Death Valley's actually on the other side of that mountain, believe it or not.
Tough climb.
Yeah. We just caught a glimpse of what we think is Whitney. It's way off there right now. These are some Joshua trees. We're coming up out of somewhere. We stopped here at the ranger station. There's the hill right there. Right there she is. Hopefully we'll be somewhere right in there tomorrow, and then we go up over this way behind all those little points, ching 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 ching, and end up on top. Okay, well, we're here at our little campsite, getting ourselves sort of semi-organized. It's our little tent. Over here's where we lock our food up so the bears don't get us. And of course, right up here's the highway. We got the trash cans right across the street. And better yet, we got the bathroom and running water right next to the parking lot.
This is a bear canister, is where we put our food in. This is the amount of food we have to fit in here. What do you think?
Ain't happening.
Yeah. It's a little home away from home here. In the tent.
Huh?
It's our first night.
I'm reading to you.
It's so sweet. It's about 6:30. Chilly here.
Yeah, it's up. It's morning.
Good morning. Good morning.
Cooking water.
I got off of 8:30. We're finally
heading up the road for the trailhead. 160 other people gonna do what we did, and this place is a complete zoo.
Heading out. Extra food bag.
Okay, first steps on the Whitney Trail.
How many stone?
45.
45 stone?
We actually started at 8:30. We're just a few feet into the trip at this point. We're heading away from the mountain. It's always annoying. Switchback number one. Slowly, slowly. Looking back down in Owens Valley where this whole thing started yesterday.
Good morning.
Good morning.
Coming across the North Fork of the Lone Pine Creek. The agility is amazing.
This is switchback number 7,406. Well, break's over. It's about 10 minutes to 10 in the morning. Actually, it's a buck and a doe standing right here off the trail. Watch, we're just slowly, slowly. We're doing good at that. Looking back down from where we are. Oh, it's mighty scary. Mighty scary. Morning.
Morning.
Yeah, the character of the trail's changed a bit here. Came into some really big trees standing that have been here. These guys are a good 3-4 foot in diameter. Yeah, we are so close to the top. What top? The character of the trail is about to change. We're getting up into the rocky part. We're entering the Whitney Zone. Old Billy's made some headway there. Ooh, look at those switchbacks. A little precipitous here. It's like a little old juniper, I guess, here. Growing into the rock face. They call this the mule root. Switchbacks just go on and on and on and on and on down through here. Awesome. Some of the switchbacks we came up. This little lake we just passed. Thank you. Yeah, nothing to it. Nothing to it. It's just uphill.
Oh, yeah.
It's just uphill.
It's just impossible. So annoying.
So much easier if someone's carrying four.
Yeah, we just arrived at Mirror Lake. Take a break. Climbed up here. A few hundred feet above the lake. Steep and snarly and rocky. Nice rest up, Bill. Nice rest up. Eric would be proud of you. You think we were climbing a mountain at this point? Where we're heading over there, up into that cirque. Ha! Nothing to it. Getting tired, I can tell. Seems like just a few minutes ago we were there. Climbers working their way towards us here. I'm not even winded. How are you?
I'm sun tanning. I'm not tired.
Camp should be right around the corner. Should be. It's just a few more hundreds of feet. Bill made me take another break. I didn't want to, but he insisted. That's where we came up just a few minutes ago. Coming up close to 12,000 feet. It's after 3 o'clock in the afternoon, started at 8:30. So we're doing our slow but steady. Pretty cool lake here. Okay, we appear to have made it to Camp Trail, somewhat bedraggled. We was scouting a campsite. We found where it looks like the boys and us camped back 25 years ago, but it's really kind of off the beaten path and not any water nearby. So. Okay, we're now going to turn a worthless piece of real estate into a prime campsite. Beautiful sheer rock face across the way. And of course, no neighbors anywhere. Well, a few neighbors. Here and there, but what are you gonna do, you know? Sitting around chit-chatting. People hiding in the rocks here. Uella, we have the camp. We just got water upstream out of a nice snowmelt, and we're iodining that and getting ourselves organized for tonight and tomorrow.
Chicken and noodles.
Say what?
Chicken noodles.
Come on. Stoves are roaring away here. You can see people coming down off the summit. See, we're starting to lose the sun here. Gonna get cold. Anyway, it's 7 o'clock and we're laying here in the tent because we were freezing to death. Bill just
did something disgusting in it. What did you do, Bill?
I farted.
Are you sorry?
No.
We know he's not sorry. It was awful. I had to open the window. And we'll catch some sleep and then we'll go climb the hill. Right, Bill?
Night-night.
Night, Bill. Say goodnight, Bill.
Goodnight, Bill.
Yeah, hopefully the sun will be up soon and warm things up. Meantime, a cup of coffee, a candy bar, and off we go. Yeah, it's left for 6 in the morning. A little bit of disorganized chaos here. As the alpenglow hits rest at our destination for the day.
Here. Hello.
Good morning.
Yes, good morning. This is what a good day for a climb, eh?
At shortly before 7:30 in the morning, we departed our camp at 12,000 feet and began the 6-mile climb to the 14,500-foot summit.
That's our route right up through there. We'll go above the snowfield and up through to the left. We've come a long way since camp. Yeah, we're just starting into the scree field now. We're coming up alongside. Get a bit of a profile here. The actual summit is center frame right now. It's the top of Whitney right there. Poly poly, slowly, slowly. They say there's 99 switchbacks depending on how you count. And we'll find out, I suppose. Coming to a bit of a rest point. You think you make great distance, and yet you look back and go, "Hoo." And the switchbacks never end. We're being chased by people. All going faster than we are, and we don't really care, because we'll get there the same place they're going, just maybe a little later. Heading right up into there, up that crest, you may be able to see a guy walking about center frame. Here's the face of the Sierra. Eastern face, and there's the good old Mount Whitney. Ran into some icy here, big ice fall. Somebody did a lot of work to put this trail here. I'll say that. Just walking up here, come over the corner and yo, man. It's like straight down here. Man, it's like straight down here. Gonna be a great day. It's clear as a bell. No wind. Awesome. We're actually close, I would think, to the ridgecrest at this point. We have to walk that once we get up top, but we don't have a lot of elevation gains. It's not quite so bad. There's the summit once again. Somewhere out there, right? Actually, it's that rounded thing, not that real peak. It's the more rounded thing right there. Ooh. Continuing our slog upward. Right there, center frame, is the summit hut on Mount Whitney Summit. We're almost there. Okay, we're coming up on trail crest, which puts us on the ridge of the Sierras. This is trail crest. There's Billy. What's up, brother? All right. Top of the world, man. Look at that. Wow. What a view. And people ask why we do this foolishness. This is why. Coming up over Trail Crest. We just climbed a long way up here. We don't know exact elevation, unfortunately. I should know those kinds of things, but I don't. That ridge off in the distance, we were once much lower there. Homes. Way down there. You maybe see the tent. I can't.
There's Dennis entering Sequoia National Park on the John Muir Trail.
We're still at Trail Crest. Worked out here. It's about 13,500 feet and about 2.5 miles from the top. So we've got 1,000 feet of vertical to do yet and 2.5 miles of walking. And then, of course, we have to turn around and do what we just did in reverse. And that's the important part, because it doesn't count if you don't get back.
No, passing by. See you up there.
Okay, our little break's over and we're heading off Trail Crest and we're going around the back side of the Sierras. Ooh, this is scary, man. This just drops right straight off down there. This is actually my favorite part of the climb. It's kind of exposed and just incredible views all over here. It's just awesome. That's a couple one-dayers out there. They're busting their butts. A lot of people do a one-day on this, but I'm not quite sure why, because I don't know how you have time to enjoy anything. Whew. This is the backside. Long, kind of boulder walk. We'll actually come out around about mid-frame. We've arrived at one of the many windows. Hi, Billy. Oh, here you go. Really spectacular view.
Vista.
Wolf Commas events, sort of. You can see the route of our ascent up to Trail Crest. You can see our route in here. You can see in the background the curved dome. That's the summit dome of Mt. Whitney. It's actually amazing how narrow the ridge is here. Some really spectacular rock. Having fun yet?
Absolutely.
There's the top, bro. Holy cow, getting closer. Sort of closer, kind of. Sort of, kind of. This trail around the backside is just a huge amount of just ups and downs. We're now going rapidly down again. Trail of places gets amazingly narrow. You can really get hurt down here if you're not careful. That's the goal still way off in the distance. Now we got the day runners heading back down. They touched the top and claimed their victory. Came to yet another of these famous windows. Let's give you an idea of the height and depth. It's just beautiful here today. Couldn't be nicer. There's a very little wind here. The view's just incredible. We'll say, bro.
Beautiful, beautiful, beautiful.
The ridge is just incredibly narrow. Here's, just drop straight down through here. Here's the trail, and then just plummets down this side. That little break spot here.
Just one break after. What a view.
And walk right up here and just jump right out of here. Just goes down there. A few gazillion feet.
We're getting there. Won't be first, but hey, we'll get there.
That's the route to the top. Give you some idea of scale. Top's on that round ridge, left to center frame. Just working our way through this boulder field. Actually, it's good going, and then it gets kind of like, whoops, where'd the trail go? Whew, nice view. Yeah, we're getting right up in here now. Back for once we cometh all the way along here. Way back there. We've got a bunch of down traffic now. We're taking our good old time. Sliding our way up the side here. Whew. We're gotta be at 14,000 feet at this point. I certainly hope and pray. Well up on the summit dome, and we're getting to turn, make our approach to the top, which is off out there somewhere. Oh my. At this point, one's into the pressure breathe. Rest walk mode of survival. As well, we're just about there. I'd say we're just a few minutes from the summit. Well, we certainly pray we are. Hey, Billy. How we doing?
Can I buy any oxygen?
Fresh out. Should be just over that break. Please just be over that break. It's a beautiful, beautiful, beautiful day for climbing a mountain. See forever. There's the top.
How you doing?
Finally made it. Tantalizing close. Comes the mule. Hey, mule. You having fun yet? Passing the bunker. Coming up on the crest here. Howdy.
Howdy, how you doing?
Doing good, much better. Okay, be tagging another high point. Top of the world, the hut from the opposite side.
Means we made it. Unless you doubt it. Look at my feet on top of the mountain.
Okay, officially that's the top. And that's my foot. See it moving? Well, kind of. I sort of lied because actually the real top is right there, and it's like too hard to get to. Okay, I decided not to cheat. This is the real one. It's pretty well destroyed, but this is the highest point in the lower 48 states. Everything else in the lower 48 is downhill from here.
And Bill's trying to phone home yet.
Last point, lower 48. Can you hear me breathing there, buddy? We'll probably be up here about an hour and head back down to our hot tub. We're camping at 12,000.
Here's where we originated our climb. A place called Whitney Portal. Way down in here. Here's the trail we came up way off in the distance. And I mean way off in the distance, the water. This little troublemaker. Don't think about it. Don't even think about that pack. What do you want, you rodent? Get out of here.
Made it.
You go, boy!
People often ask what's in the cabin. Well, you can only get into a small part of it. There's not much. Some graffiti. An old wooden floor. Plaque down here that says extreme danger from lightning, you get your head blown off if you sleep in here. It was erected by the Smithsonian in 1909. The old signing of the register ritual, we have to do that. Leave your mark on the mountain. Comes that darn marmot again, looking for a handout. I think we got on top about a quarter of one. I'm not sure.
1248.
Like I said, about a quarter of one. And you stay away from my pack or I'll have you for lunch. You hear me? Okay, honey. It's 20 after 1. And we fed the marmot. He's happy. I think it's time we get off this hill. What do you think?
People still coming up here?
Mm-hmm.
Yeah. A little different pace going down than up, I noticed here. Still have lots of up traffic, kind of surprising. Well, in a little under 20 minutes, actually, we've dropped completely down off the summit dome, and we're coming around the back side, behind the windows again, where we took our last break. Okay, we're 30 minutes off the summit, coming up on the window where we took our extended break before we
headed up to the top. And we're down there is home. Gives you an idea how far you can come when you're coming down. Making good pace here. One thing for sure, this section behind the needles, the windows, it's got to be the snarliest trail. It just has some really nasty sections. Narrow little part of the ridge here. The really aggravating part is we got to go up, way up through all this. Bill just described this experience very well. He said it sucks. And I have to agree. But hey, it's what you got to pay. We're sitting here on break and we noticed these funny white poofy things in the sky. We haven't seen any of those time we've been out here. Down there around that corner is where we turn off and hopefully blast on down off of here. Yeah, over here, yeah, as Bill pointed out, over in here is our trail. You can actually see it wending its way down through here. Yeah, we got the last bit of uphill on our descent. This is the climb up to trail crest. We got here in about an hour and a half from the summit. It's 3 o'clock in the afternoon. Well, we've made trail crest and I'm willing to certify this is the toughest part of the climb, bar nothing else. It's just this kick butt uphill you don't need. You can see Billy's long shadow there. The top of the frames, our 12,000 foot home sweet home. This downhill stuff is a lot easier than the uphill stuff. You can make really good time. A whole bunch of people out ahead of us took a little break here. We're 20 minutes away from trail junction. Got some clouds floating. Home's getting closer. Okay, we're clearly on the downhill side of this thing. There's a home. We'll be there a few hundred yards. Well, we've made it back to our pleasure palace. It's 4:41 in the afternoon. I gotta say, I'm dog tired. I don't know about Billy. I think he's dog tired and won't admit it. He was begging me to go get us water for him, but ain't gonna happen. So we'll settle in here, get our water, purify that, and make some dinner and die for the night.
Congratulations, Sir Edward Stomp.
Good climb.
Here
we
go.
Oh, I'll wait till later. Aha.
I'm gonna cut that part out.
I screwed up on top of the mountain. So to validate, I summited with the wind shirt that is doing every mountain. Since the beginning.
Cool. Well, I know you took it up. I saw you pack it, and I saw you unpack it, so I'll be your witness. Hold it up there, Bill. See if it fits. Oh, gosh. One leg. That's amazing.
Before I had kids.
Okay. It's night three. Actually, it's 2 minutes after seven. Uncle Willie here had to go to bed. He's sleepy and his back hurts.
Who jumped in right behind me?
You're truly. Anyhow, we're going to sign off and tomorrow morning we're going to get out of bed about 9. If we're lucky, throw our packs on our backs and head down off this mountain, eh, boo?
Righto.
Okay, cheery bye. Oh, look. It's morning, dear.
I won't come out.
Managed to get a little ice on our pond overnight. Well, the sun's just up, obviously. And people are heading up the hill. And it's nice to know that it's still there, too. We'll be packing up here shortly. Not too quickly, but shortly. Heading down to the car and to a hot shower. Bye.
Well, the tent's down, the packs are pretty well packed. We're about to roll out. It's 8:45. We had a lazy morning, we're on the big rush. We've been walking for a few minutes. We're kind of on the plateau where our camp was. We're not gonna start some serious drop in elevation. By the end of the day, we'll be down there in Owens Valley in that clump of trees, which is the town of Lone Pine. Just caught our first glimpse of Mirror Lake there in the lower left. We're doing a real rapid descent here. We've reached the level of Mirror Lake. It's about 10:45. Just had a nice break. Now we've reached the meadow at the outpost camp and retard there's crossing the creek. It's a real pretty place. You're allowed to camp here. It's one of the only other places besides Camp Trail where you can camp. A real pretty place, lots of big trees and open areas and a nice waterfall. But I think it's a big grouse sitting here. I'm sure it doesn't like me. It's interesting that it's sitting right here along the trail. Bill pointed it out, I walked right by it. The trail's just like right here.
Master Dan.
So we just took our last kind of big break. It's our first view of the Whitney Portal Road. We have a mile or two of downhill to go yet till we get to the car. But most of the trip's behind. And we're looking forward to a stop at the Portal store and a cold one. See you then. Okay, last couple of steps. Wrapping up the trip. Comes Billy. It's 2:15 in the afternoon. Good job, Will. This is the famous Whitney Portal store, home of cold beers and great hamburgers. Kind of a nice place to just relax before we jump in the car and head back to civilization. Okay, we found the car. Now we have to empty our bear canisters and get ready to return them to Mr. Ranger. Frontier Best Western in Lone Pine. Chance to relax, slept about 1 million hours. So mid-morning, we're gonna head for the valley. say goodbye to our friend Mt. Whitney. We're heading back into Death Valley. We're at Father Crowley Point. It's about half a mile off the hard road. You can see the road going down into the valley. Amazing place. Oh no, a tourist.
What I propose here is we put a dam down that end.
Okay, yeah.
Fill this up with water.
Yeah.
All kinds of lakefront properties. We're gonna make a lot of money here, Bob.
All right. Sand dunes at Stovepipe Wells. Sea level, and this is the borax works. That's the processing plant. Obviously one of the 20 mule team of wagons. The lowest land in the United States, 200 and some feet below sea level. A little toasty here, but not terribly hot. After spending a day hanging out at such Las Vegas hotspots as the Nuclear Test Site Museum, Bill and I managed to find our way back to Pennsylvania on September 17th. Once again, ready to plan a new adventure. Hey Bill, what's next?
See me running now? You just wait. It gets better.
Oh, that was dumb.
Yeah, well, for the sake of a video.
Whoa, shit.
the parking shot creates miles of outtake because we gotta get ready and then we gotta walk back up the trail. Put her on the foot brake.